what's up? Today we're going to talk about the best way to price your home when you're putting it on the market. I'm Matt Defeedy with Realty Executives Elite Homes in Nutley, New Jersey. And one of the most important things that you can do when putting your home on the market is determine how to price the property. Now, there are a couple of different ways to do this. We're going to discuss two. We're going to discuss retail pricing and we're going to discuss auction pricing. All right. And that's what we're going to do here. So there is this methodology of underpricing properties to cause a bidding war. And we call that auction pricing. So you take a home that, say, is worth $400,000 and you price it for $375,000 in hopes that you're going to cause a bidding war. And that can backfire on you. Okay, that can definitely backfire on you because I've noticed that when people do get caught up in FOMO, fear of missing out, they usually regret right away what they have done. And I've seen a lot of contracts where buyers have done this and maybe put way over the ask price and regretted it and pulled back and backed out of the contract. And now you're back to square one. Okay, that's one pitfall with that type of pricing. There are many more, but that's just one of them. The other one is pricing it at retail. Now, what I mean by pricing it at retail is on the market, turnkey, ready to go. So if you walk through the house and the house needs, say, new windows, some paint, maybe a new door, maybe some flooring needs to be fixed, you know, you're going to do all that work before you put the home on the market. And with our business, time is always of the essence, especially with how quick the market can change. So let's look at that retail situation for a moment. So if we look at it and say the home is worth $400,000 and it needs $10,000 worth of work, are you going to put the $10,000 into it? Or are you better off pricing it at the value it should be, at $390,000? That will make a world of difference because you're pricing it with its defects already in place. And when you market the property, you market it at the price it should be marketed at, or you can take the time, energy, effort, and aggravation to do the work to the property and have it priced at that retail. So those are two types of pricing methods. Actually, three is the actual market value, which I like. Actual market value gets rid of all the time, energy, and aggravation of making repairs that you most likely do not want to do. And at this time in the market, end of January, early February, you may not have the time to do those repairs at the home. And the one comment that I was taught a long time ago is price cures defects. And if you price your home at the market value at the time of the market, you're going to attract more buyers to that property. When it's underpriced, a lot of people think, hey, what's wrong with this house? Why is it underpriced? Then there's also the opposite side of it. When people overprice their home and it sits on the market and it gathers days on market, which is a death sentence to a listing, when it's 30, 60, 90 days, people want to know, hey, what's wrong with this house? Why is it sitting on the market? There's that sweet spot of pricing your home at what the actual market value is and marketing the property that way. That's the best way to do it. Matt Defeedy, Realty Executives, Elite Homes. If you have any questions, reach out to me. Love to hear from you.